Who doesn't love adding type hints to Python code? Okay, maybe that's the wrong question. Who doesn't love the idea of using type hints in Python code to keep it correct? I know I love it. What I don't love is adding type hints to existing Python code, and I don't think anybody else does either. Well, you know what I'd like? I'd like to take a program without type hints and automatically generate type hints for every function that runs. And then I could generate type stubs from that or apply those hints directly to my code. That'd be a big time saver. Well, as it turns out, such a thing is in fact a thing. It's called Monkeytype, and it was created by the fine folks at Instagram, who have a great deal of Python code in their backend. Monkeytype generates static type annotations for code by running the code and examining the code's runtime behavior. So if you have, for instance, a test suite with full coverage for a particular piece of code, you can use that to automatically stub out type hints on a code base that needs it. So let's take a look at a simple example in action. I have here a small program that consists of two modules. One is the main module, which is our entry point, and another is a module in the namespace utils.math. That module has one function in it, add, and you'll notice we have no type hints anywhere on this code. Now to generate type hints using Monkeytype, we want to run code that executes as many of the functions in the code base as possible. That's not hard when we only have one function. All we have to do is run our entry point, since that invokes that one function. And to do this, we use Monkeytype's command run. So we type Monkeytype run main.py. Now when this code executes, you'll notice we now have a SQLite3 file appearing in our code's root directory. That is the result of the runtime analysis, and it contains the type information gathered at runtime for this code base. Now we can apply that type information in a couple of different ways. One is by using Monkeytype stub to generate stubs, which are printed to standard out for a given module. So if we type Monkeytype stub utils.math and run that, we get a dump of what the type hints will look like for that module. And then we could save those as a .pyi file like this, Monkeytype stub utils.math arrow utils/math.pyi. Now another option is to apply the type hints directly to the file. Now this we can do with Monkeytype apply utils.math. Remember, this is going to actually change your source code, so you only want to do this when you have source control set up to let you revert if you don't like the results. So if we run this, you'll notice our math module now has type hints applied directly to it. Let's revert all of these changes and modify the example slightly. We're now going to invoke our function using both integers and floats, and we're going to erase our old trace file, and we're going to rerun our trace from scratch. So now, when we create our stubs, you'll notice it shows a different type signature. Our function's hinting is now using either ints or floats for both arguments, based on the fact that during the run of our program, we've called it both ways. So it infers that both of these are going to be valid. Now, all of this is a very minimal contrived example, but it should give you an idea of what's possible. Also, this isn't the only way we can use Monkeytype, that is, from the command line. We can also use it like any other Python module. We can import it and use it programmatically, so we can check the code of an entire code base without having to grovel over each module manually like this. For a code base that doesn't yet have type hints, you can automate the process best by way of a test suite if you have one. The more coverage you have with a test suite, the more hints you'll be able to generate. Also keep in mind, it's going to be your responsibility to determine if the generated hints reflect how you want your program to behave. In other words, if you have a union of types in a given definition, like I just demonstrated, and you really want just one type, you're going to have to do the legwork to figure out which caller for that function is generating the wrong type information or superfluous type information. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.